What is going on, y'all? Faiz Sports Talk back at it with another video. And yes, I am doing a very, very, very late recap video to the Bears week 7 drubbing against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, in which they, of course, lost 38-3. And I have a very good reason for why I'm late. You guys know I usually get the videos out right after the game, the same day. At latest, maybe a day after, but this is a few days after. And the reason for that is, if you guys haven't seen, I made a post about it. If you guys follow me on social media, you might have seen it. I ended up getting married over the weekend, folks. So yeah, couldn't miss my own wedding. I had to, of course, attend. Obviously, I was ecstatic, and I'm very grateful that I was able to find the love of my life. And so maybe I'll make a vlog about it, or maybe I'll make another separate video just talking about, you know, a little life update here. But yeah, that's the reason why. And so in these next few weeks, if you see a little bit less in terms of the content, it's because, you know, trying to acquiesce to my new married life, and certainly is fun and exciting, and I'm loving every second of it. But that's the reason why, folks. So no excuses here. You know, the work has to continue, and it will. And so that's why I want to bring you guys my recap video about the Bears' loss to the Bucs. So let's get into it. All right, so I'll be honest, of course, I did get to watch only bits and pieces of the game initially, the live game itself, because of all the wedding festivities that were going on. But then I went back and watched the game again, and just to kind of obviously be able to analyze and provide you guys the input on what exactly happened here. So if you all remember, I predicted the Bears to lose this game to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. My score was relatively close, 27-17. This loss was not even close. The Bears almost got shut out. 38-3. Bears managed to put up a field goal. So the loss isn't surprising, and it shouldn't surprise anybody. The Bucs are defending Super Bowl champions, for crying out loud. It should be the way the Bears lost. And this has been my issue for the past season and a half, two seasons now, is that against good competition, the Bears get crushed. They're not even competitive sometimes. And that's a big problem. But let's just focus on this game itself and talk about what exactly went wrong here. And I'd love to just say everything, because that's what it felt like. Folks, the Bears just couldn't get anything going on offense. And defensively, you just got carved up by the GOAT, Tom Brady. 4 touchdown passes. Chris Godwin, 8 for 111 and a touchdown. Mike Evans caught 3 touchdowns. Leonard Fournette ran for 1. I mean, look, it's the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. It is the defending Super Bowl champions. But you got to be more competitive, right? You got to be more competitive. And look, we'll start with Justin Fields. We'll start with Justin Fields, all right? 22 for 32, 184 yards, 0 touchdown passes, and 3 interceptions. Justin Fields has not been playing well. He hasn't, all right? And again, you could say, look, Faiz, that's a problem. You know, Justin Fields should start showing some signs of progress and whatnot. Look, obviously, it's not encouraging that he's not playing well, but every single rep he's getting here, every single rep is valuable. And I, no chance in heck, I want to go back to Andy Dalton. Zero chance. Even in losses, Justin Fields is getting valuable game reps. Now, performance-wise, not a great performance at all. This offense, similar to my complaint, and I hate bringing this up, but similar to my complaint about the Bears' utilization of Mitchell Trubisky when he was here, it does not look like the offense is being suited to Justin Fields' strength. He's being treated as a pure pocket passer. There is not enough to accommodate his running game. And I know he's not a running quarterback. He's not Lamar Jackson or a prime Cam Newton. I'm not saying that. He's a very accurate thrower. But what I'm saying is, there is not enough of a game plan around bootlegs, around play action, around Justin Fields' strengths. And you might be saying, Faiz, I feel like you're just defending Justin Fields, even though he had a terrible performance. I'm not defending Justin Fields. I'm just letting you know that for a rookie quarterback, yeah, he didn't play well. But again, he's a rookie quarterback. He's learning. He's going up against the defending Super Bowl champions. And, you know, more often than not, you're going to be in a position where, you know, you're not going to play too well. He should have played better. He absolutely should have. But it's kind of up to the coaches as well to put him in positions to succeed. And in this game, he was just not put in any position to succeed, right? So you take a look at the weapons. Cole Kmet, 5 catches, 43 yards. Darnell Mooney, 2 for 39. A-Rob, 2 for 16. Herbert, 5 for 33 catches. Khalil Herbert actually had a very, he was the only bright spot here. Nobody runs on Tampa. Nobody runs on Tampa Bay. He ran for 100 yards. So Khalil Herbert, looking like he's got a bright future here. Very, very encouraging what I'm seeing from Khalil Herbert. But look, I'm not trying to absolve Justin Fields of any blame here, right? You got to go out there and play. And he made some bad throws. He made some awful throws. And he had that interception where he tried to force it to A-Rob, and A-Rob slipped and he got picked off. So to me, Justin Fields needs to play better. But think about this, right? Think about this for a second here. What's easier to fix, getting a new quarterback or getting a new coaching staff? Getting a new coaching staff. Obviously, we've been looking for a quarterback forever. And so it's too early to make any sort of conclusion on Justin Fields. But I do know we've got 4 years of tape on Matt Nagy and his offense. And I get it. He's not running the play calling, but it's still his offense in the sense of, you know, he is the head coach of the team, and the overall success of the team will obviously fall on Matt Nagy. And in 4 years, it's been a pathetic offense. Pathetic offense. Quarterback keeps changing. Foles, Trubisky, Dalton, Fields. Results stay the same. Bad offense. And so my point is, it is much easier for the Bears to move on from their coaching staff than it is from their quarterback. And I'm not saying they should move off of Justin Fields, obviously not. But what I'm saying is Matt Nagy keeps making it so much easier for him to get fired at the end of the season. And at this point, I would lean towards Matt Nagy getting fired. The Bears have a daunting schedule. You knew that. And nobody is asking for, you know, victories against these elite teams. But what we are asking for is competitive football and a little bit of respect here. 38-3 is not acceptable. It's not acceptable. It's just not. That's a pathetic performance. In today's NFL, all the rules are geared towards the offense. You're putting up 3 points. You're putting up 3 points. In Tampa Bay secondary, it's trash. You can throw on Tampa. You can't run on him. You can throw on him. Couldn't do anything. So Justin Fields is to blame. Coaching staff is to blame. Obviously, the offense was awful. Bill Lazor didn't do a good job. Defense was bad as well, folks. 38 points given up to the Bucs offense. I mean, they got whatever they wanted. So all around, this was just an ugly performance from the Bears. This is one of those games where you just burn the tape and you just move on. You're just trying to move on. That's pretty much it. There's really nothing else you can do at this point, right? Because even at the start of the season, I told you guys, it was not about wins or losses with Justin Fields. It was about development. And I'm just not even seeing the development here. I'm not even seeing the development. I don't even care about the wins or loss because the Bears are not a Super Bowl contender. I care about the development. I want to see more of it. Why is the offense always in such a struggle, right? Why is Justin Fields not being put in a position to succeed? Why does it feel like the offense is always like pulling teeth to move the football? I swear, it's archaic. And I remember I was listening to a podcast and somebody mentioned this. They said the Bears, the game should be displayed in black and white because that's how archaic their offense is, right? And so that's where, again, I struggle with this a lot. I'm not trying to absolve Justin Fields. He did play bad, but he's a young kid. He's a rookie. You as a coaching staff need to put him in a position to succeed. So overall, folks, my thoughts on this game is you just got your you-know-what kicked, right? There's everything I could point out that went wrong, right? The passing offense was awful. Khalil Herbert was the lone bright spot. The defense was awful. Everything went wrong in this game, right? So there's really no point in me pointing out, oh, if we did this, we could have won. If we did that, we could have. No, we need to do everything better to win this game. It wasn't even competitive. So that's where I'm at here. Again, burn the tape, move on to the next one here. But it's just getting more and more clear. Matt Nagy is not the head coach. That should be the head coach of the Bears moving forward. It's just not the case. So let me know what you guys think. Leave a comment down below if you agree or disagree. As always, thanks for watching.